After 4 years as British champion, Henry Cooper meets Muhammad Ali, known in this time as Cassius Clay. Wembley, London, June 18th, 1963.
So here we go. The fight of the year, Clay from the right-hand corner against Cooper of Britain. A lot of people think that Cooper's big chance is to go in early with his left hook and try and nail Clay. Clay, 6'2½", Cooper, 6'1½". Clay really is a fine figure. Cooper's left shoulder, and that comes from Clay's nose. That left hand of Cooper's is right into Clay's face, and he's scoring heavily with it, and he's hurting the American. A sensational start to this fight. And Cooper right on top with half a minute to go in the first. By the British champion, the handsome Cassius Clay, coming out for round three after the shock of his life in the first round. The rain has stopped. The excitement has really started among the crowd here who've seen Cooper take the fight to Clay. And these 40 or 50,000 people in Wembley are all on Henry Cooper's side. Cooper's left eye patched up now. Still he hooks the left hand. And now he's cut over the left eye. Henry Cooper is cut over the left eye, and it looks to me like a very bad cut indeed. This is tragedy for Cooper in the third round. With only 40 seconds gone, and Cooper is very badly cut over the left eye. That handsome face of the American Negro, completely unmarked. Cooper trying to nail him in the third if he can. There's no telling now how long he's got to go, Cooper, with that eye. A minute left in the third. Treating Cooper. His arms are down by his hips. Just using his feet to keep away from Cooper. This is complete cheat on the part of Clay, who feels that he's got it in the bag because of that eye. Half a minute to go in the third. Clay has taken all of Cooper's punches and stood up to them. In this round now. He's just threatening, and he's teasing Cooper. He's trying to make Cooper look small in the third round, and Cooper's left eye is a very sorry sight indeed. It really is. It's cut above and below. Danny Holland, with the swap sticks in his mouth there, is going to have to work really hard to try and staunch the flow of blood from that eye. It really is a bad one. Clay away completely unmarked and looking set for victory because of this handicap to Cooper's left eye. Well, they've worked on it. Tommy Little chasing Cooper's seconds up. Round four. Sitting down the ringside is one of Clay's 11 managers, Bill Faversham, and he called out to Clay in the interval, cut out the funny business and get down to work. So the Clay people are not too happy with their man. He was certainly teasing Cooper in the third. This is not the way to go about things when you're a world heavyweight contender. And Cooper's eye already bleeding again in the fourth round. Above and below, two streams of blood. And poor Cooper, he's putting his left glove up there to that eye as though he can hardly believe his bad luck. One looks for a sign that a left hook from Cooper can really hurt this man, but apart from the opening minute, he hasn't seemed to hurt Clay very much with his back. He's put as many left hooks in as he can get, and Clay has taken the ball somewhat contemptuously. And now Clay is just jabbing casually with his left hand. Seems to be halfway somewhere else. He's just beating Cooper almost as a plaything here, but that's the sort of chance you can take once too often. And if Henry nails him, anything might happen.
Cooper's left eye is really
has come in from Cooper's corner, and Tommy Lewis is looking at it.
A sudden and dramatic ending as young Cassius Clay makes good his prediction of a fifth round KO after coming off the canvas in the fourth. It now appears to everyone that this young fighter is destined to become heavyweight champion of the world.